sign language. It's okay. But how did I learn? Well, there are three times you need to know about. First, I was very young, just a little girl. Second is when I learned to fingerspell. Third, for our first one, I learned my first signs. I was very young. My cousin, she was deaf, and my aunt, she used sign language with my cousin. My cousin, she also had cystic. So signing was a way that she could kind of communicate, but it wasn't perfect. So with my cousin, my family learned one, two, three, just some signs. I knew water, mom, dad, and maybe that's all. For time after that, that was all I knew. And I grew up, and I learned the probably 10 years old. I was a safety patrol. So I would help children. So I would have their class, and then I would walk with them to when I would go to the class, up on the wall, there was a poster up on the wall, and it had the ABCs in sign language. I thought, wow, I want to learn. So Monday, I would go in, I would think, hey, look at the poster, see how sign. Try and remember and practice A, A, A. But try to remember. Tuesday I would go A and then learn B, A, B. And I would practice, practice, practice. B, A. Ba, ab. When I know C, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I would learn more ABCs. And at last, I learned all of them. One time, I would always fingerspell them myself. So my hands, I would put into but not with people. That was the second one. No, before my third part of learning. Before that one. This is a different cousin. My cousin, she came and lived with my family. My sister. She's hearing, but she learned sign language. She showed me some of what she was learning. She is the one who showed me gesture stories. Oh, I love. See her making the gestures. Wow. Her hands, beautiful. It was fun. I loved it. Loved it. Then, when I was much older, for our third, I went to BYU. My first semester. Learning sign language. He taught me and all of our friends learn maybe 5 or 6, 7 of us all learned sign language together. And so we lived in dorms. Yeah, and so when we would eat, in, you know, a big dining hall. And there were lots of people. Big circle table would sit around. I loved the circle tables. We had hard to hear sometimes. So when that happened, we would sign, "Hello, how are you doing? What happened in your class? Oh, I need to study. A test? Oof, no, bad." We talk and had fun. My roommate, she learned as well. And we would talk a lot in sign language. And that is when I learned lots of sign language. The next semester, I thought, I need to take a class. Took a class, and my teacher, his name was Julio. I love Julio. He is the best. He is deaf. His face, wow, so expressive. Could show you what he meant. Oh, wow, he was so good. I wanted to sign just like him. I took maybe 2 or 3 classes from Julio. And then I took a class named ASL grammar. I did not do good. Did bad with that class, with ASL grammar. Part of it, I had a boyfriend, and I don't know if I worked like I should have, but I got a D in the class. Yeah, not good. After that, I didn't want to take more ASL classes. That was my last class. And that's how I learned sign language. Now I'm not in the USA. I don't have deaf people who talk sign language well with ASL. Here they talk Auslan. It's a different language. And I make videos, but my sign language is fine, but and that's how I learned sign language. If you want to learn sign language, the best way is to learn with friends, and if you can, and with a deaf teacher. You need to have a deaf teacher. Hearing teacher, it's just not the same. You need a deaf teacher. My videos, they're only maybe a little bit of practice, not for learning.